हेलो नमस्ते केम छो माय सेल्फ मिहिर चेवली टुडे आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू मेनी ग्रेट फूड्स आइटम्स ऑफ इंडिया इफ यू आर अ फूड लवर वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड एंड नॉट देन यू विल श्योरली हैव अ क्रेविंग आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस लेट्स स्टार्ट। आवर प्रायोरिटी फॉर लिविंग इज रोटी कपड़ा एंड मकान इट मीन फूड क्लोथ्स एंड होम। These three things are necessary to live our life, and for our generation, one more thing is added, and that's the internet. And today I am going to talk about one of them, and that's about food. Here are some interesting facts and some GK about Indian food. Indian food is said to be based on six kind of taste. That's sweet, madura, salty, sour, pungent, bitter, and astringent, means kasya. India is the largest producer of the spices in the world. It is the land of the rice that grows unbelievable varieties like white, red, sticky, even black. Black rice is found only in India and in China. India is a home to both jalokia, one of the hottest chili in the world, also called ghost chili. World largest producer of milk is India. So now I will tell you the amazing food item from various corner of the India. Let's go. We are starting from my home state Gujarat. When you ask food of Gujarat, then first thing will comes in mind that phaphra and jalebi and also dhokla. In many festival, phaphra is the most preferable snacks. Phaphra is a rectangular shape and yellowish in complexion. It's made from besan, mean gram flour, oil, ajwain mean carom seeds, paprikar and salt. When you come to Gujarat, then don't miss this delicious rich food. Price is around ₹30 per plate. It means $0.45 per plate. When you hear the name of the phaphra in Gujarat, then automatically jalebi include in the list. They both are like siblings. Jalebi is made by deep frying maida flour, means plain flour, batter in pestle or circular shape, which are then soaked in sugar syrup. This dessert can be served warm or cold. Jalebi is eaten with curd or jalebi along with optional other flavors such as kevra, scented water. My suggestion is that take jalebi with the rabri, make you flavor gasted. Price is similar as phaphra, ₹30 per plate, $0.45 per plate. After that, most lovable snack comes in the list is dabeli. Basically, dabeli is a spicy, tangy, and sweet potato filling inside a bun. More specifically, the Indian bun called as a pav. This is with the spicy and a sweet chutney and some pomegranate, grapes, onion, and sev. Dabeli means pressed in the Gujarati language. It was invented in 1960. The people of Gujarat very sweet, and that's why their foods are also more delicious. There are an uncountable list of snacks and namkins like khaman and dokla, phatra, thepla, gugra, bakharwadi, khakra, mathiya, chorafari, singh bhujia, and busu, means mixture of namkins. Don't miss this one when we visit to Gujarat. Come to on the main course of the Gujarati thali. The Gujarati thali consists of various dishes like ringra methinu saak, means eggplant cooked with fenugreek leaves, Gujarati katti mithi dal, sweet and sour lentil, undiyu, mixed vegetable prepared with the spinach paste, bindi sambaria, lady finger curry, alu rasila, means potato and potato thin curry, steamed basmati rice, basmati khichdi, chapati, methina thepla and bakri with kachumbal salad among with the various types of chutneys. Gujarati household has at least three fresh vegetable dishes, one dry dal, a wet dal kadhi, kathor, a sevadi, mithai, puri, rotis, steam rice, chhas and papad. There are basundi, srikhan, angur rabri and mohan thal, means milk cake, are the best sweets of Gujarat that you don't want to miss in your life. The price per plate is around 150 rupees to 1000 rupees. It means $2 to $15. You can visit Manek Chowk, Law Garden, Bhatiyari Gali, Fruktak Park in Ahmedabad for street food. And in Surat, you can visit Gangor, Kailash, Sweet Snacks, Mahesh Pav Bhaji, Jani Locho for amazing street food experience in Gujarat. Going to the next spots, and this Rajasthan. Fafra, Jalebi and Dokla are connected with Gujarat. Like this, Dal Bati and Churma is connected with Rajasthan. Number 1. Dal Bati and Churma. Dal Bati and Churma is the Rajasthani cuisine popular not only in India but across the world. This is a dish for a special occasion. Batis resemble the dumplings but are baked in the special oven. Churma is a sweet dish made with flour, jaggery of sugar and ghee. Ghee means Indian butter. Dal Bati Churma is usually served either during lunchtime or dinner time. The city of Jodhpur, Jaipur, Udaipur and Jaisalmer are famous for this Rajasthani dish. It's available in most of the shops. This will taste better than you can imagine. Price special thali Indian rupees 100. It means around $1.2. Second food of Rajasthan, that's Lal Mas. It is a meat curry prepared in a sauce of yogurt and hot spice such as red mathaniya chilies. This dish typically is very hot and rich in garlic. The gravy may be thick or liquid and is eaten with chapatis made out of wheat or maida flour. Price is around Indian rupees 150. It's around $2. Next food of Rajasthan, Gatta Curry. Rajasthani Gatta Curry or Gatte Ki Sabji is the very popular in Rajasthan vegetarian dish made from besan atta. Dumplings made from gram flour and dry spices are steamed and cooked in a spicy and tangy yogurt-based sauce. This dish tastes exceptionally good with any type of Indian flatbread like roti, chapati, paratha, puri or bakri or steamed rice. Price is around 150 rupees, it's around $2. Next food of Rajasthan and my favorite, Raj Kachori. Raj Kachori is a typical Rajasthan street food which has become very popular. It is available in all chaat shops. Raj Kachori is like a giant pani puri and is well proof and very crisp. First, mix the flour, semolina, baking powder in the bowl and make the with the water. Divide the dough into equal parts and then make puri in the round shape. Heat the oil in the embroidery and heat it well. Now fries until they become golden brown. Put them on napkins afterward to get extra oil. Mix the remaining ingredients in the second bowl with boiled mung, black and brown gram, potatoes, salt and sugar. Make hole in the middle of the kachori and fill the finished material in it. Then apply papri masala on it and simultaneously add curd chaat masala, red chili, tamarind and green chutney. Price per plate is around 75 rupees Indian rupees. It means only $1. Other street food like mirchi vada, mohan mas, pyaaj kachori and Swiss, there are lots of options like gevar, kalakand, balusai and mung ki dal ka halwa. It's delicious. Most try it in your Rajasthan tour. If you are wondering where you can have the best street food in the Rajasthan, there are a place to satisfy your craving for the Rajasthani delicacy, including like most of the shop is in Jaipur. So you are going in Rajasthan, don't miss to visit the Jaipur. Visit this place for a delicious taste. Going to the next state and it's the Punjab, the state of food. This cuisine has a rich tradition of many distinct and local ways of cooking. One is special form of tandoori cooking that's now famous in other parts of India, UK, Canada, Hong Kong, and in many parts of the world. Traditionally, Punjabi cuisine is known for its rich buttery flavor along with the extensive vegetarian and meat dishes. The main dishes include sarso da saag, a stew whose main ingredient is mustard greens, and makke di roti. Here are some famous food items of Punjab. Number one in the Punjabi food is the langar. While not being a dish, langar is an absolute must-try for everyone at least once in their life. The community kitchen of every gurudwara is open to all for service and serving. Anyone can go there and help to cook for the people as well as receive a meal. Being just simple food consisting of naan, dal and some prasad, it is one of the humblest meal you will have while sitting with people across caste, creeds, gender, and everyone is treated equally here. Don't miss langar experience at Amritsar Gurudwara. Price free of cost for all people. First dish of Punjab is butter chicken, the king of all Punjabi dishes. While chicken may very well be called the national bird of Punjab, butter chicken is the crowning jewel of the food of Punjab. No celebration can be complete without this dish. This creamy gravy dish is lightly spiced and paired up with either naan or rumali roti. Price per plate is 150 Indian rupees, it means $2. Second is a lassi, a drink known far and wide. Lassi is something Punjabis pride themselves in. Though it can be salty, the original lassi as is become famous is sweet with a dollop of cream and butter to make it as rich as you can. Flavors like mango, rose or strawberry is added this day to give it a twist while beating the summer heat. Almost all restaurants serve this even if they are not Punjabi joints, which show the popularity of this humble drink. Price is 45 rupees only, it means $0.6. Next is Amritsari Kulcha. Amritsari Kulcha is a crisp as well as soft leavened bread which is stuffed with boiled and mashed potatoes and spices. This bread is similar to naan. This is the best and easy kulcha recipe ever. Amritsari Kulcha with chole or dal makhani is an authentic Punjabi meal of Amritsar. Price is start from ₹35 to 150. It means $0.47 to $2. Other street food of Punjab like Rajma Chawal Rice, Paneer Tikka, Amritsari Fish, Shakkarpara, that you don't wanna miss. Places for best food experience in Punjab, there's Golden Temple and other Gurudwaras for langars, and for other items you can visit Baba's Kitchen, Haveli, Brothers Amritsari Daba, the Kulcha Lane, Kesar Da Daba at Punjab and in Ludhiana. After the dinner, must try pan. Fire pan is basically an extreme version of regular pan that just happen to be on fire when it goes into your mouth. Jagdish Chaurasia ya Pan Bandar is the smallest street food stall in Vileparle, Mumbai that sells the most unique and exotic version of pan, such as ice pan, fire pan, chocolate pan, fruit pan and many more. Not only in Mumbai, Maharashtra, but you can get it in many places all over India. That's all for today. This is only 15% variety which I saw today. If you like this episode, then hit the like button. We will make the part 2. And subscribe our channel for more updates. Thank you guys. Have a nice day. Namaste. What's up guys, I am Mihir and today I am bring to you another video on Indian street food. So all the foodies out there, sit tight as today I am going to share some great dishes from different states would give you a serious FOMO of what you having losing out. So let's get started. Before the video starts, I am going to show some food that will force you to take home with you. First, let me tell you our country's national drink, the chai tea. Guys, trust me, it's not just a hot beverage substitute to coffee. Here in India, we treat it as the drink to settle down our day throughout the kind of like a first step to start discussing something. People are made here for tea. The chai tea found in the Western world at Starbucks and other coffee shops is not actually traditional chai. Most of the time, American chai teas are picked with sweeteners and additives that are not found in traditional chai tea recipes. Indian chai tea is a robust blend of spice, herbals, and tea. For centuries, it has been reversed for its health benefits in Ayurvedic medicine and Indian holistic healing system. After that, enlist and that you can take it with you, and that's mango. Mango. So when you came to India between April to August, never miss eating Indian mango. There are lots of types of Indian mango like Hafus, Kesar, Langro, Rajapuri and many others. If you taste Kesar mango, then I am sure you will be a fan of that. And that's my challenge. Kesar is an intentionally sweet mango that cannot fail to be satisfying. Kesar means saffron and the taste of the mango like actual saffron. Price is around 100 Indian rupees per kg. It means $1.33 per kg or rupees 30 to 50 per piece. It means $0.5 per piece. There are 2-3 more food items left which you can take home with you when you surrounding in Indian street. And there's gooseberry and other berries, tamarind and many other. When you visiting Indian street and if you found these vendors, then don't miss buying from them. They also call as Imli Wala. Now come to on the point, in the previous video we talked about some food from Gujarat, Rajasthan and Punjab which you should not miss in live. The video link of part 1 is given below in the description. And now in this video we will moving beyond Punjab. Let's move to the most beautiful place, and that's Leh Ladakh. The first food of Leh Ladakh is Momo. Momo is a very famous dish in entire India. It is a dumpling with different stuffing in them depending on whether it's vegetarian or non-vegetarian. The dumplings are then cooked in vessel called mokto, where the vessel at the bottom contains water and the other three vessels on the top having small holes. For the steam to pass and cook the momos, hold the dumplings. It is eaten with a kind of spicy chutney, but can also be eaten alongside ketchup for those of you who don't like much spice. Next food from Leh Ladakh is Thukpa. Thukpa, which is just the noodle soup, is a very famous dish that is made in Ladakh. The flour is kneaded, the broth is cooked containing onion, tomato, garlic and other vegetables if the veg and mutton if non-vegetable. You can find this boat of food at Leh Market. Leh Market is 4.1 km away from the Leh Airport. After this, we move to Uttar Pradesh. First food from UP is mutton kofta. This one winner on the dinner table. It can be served dried as kebabs or with a thick gravy which goes well with basmati rice. This delectable mutton kofta recipe tastes the best when paired with cooked rice. Next, kebab paratha. It was considered as a royal dish in past years and you could spot the vendors selling in every street. It is a favorite evening time snack of the youth living here. The veg or non-veg kebabs are being rolled in the paratha with green chutney and sliced onion. Now look into some sweets of Uttar Pradesh, and that's black carrot halwa, moti chur ke laddu and petha, especially the anguri petha. Place for these sweets: Nirala Mishtan Bandar, Loknath Bazar, Allahabad. A quintessential Indian experience. Unless you have done this walk and eaten the goodies, you cannot call yourself as Indian foodie. Price of all sweets between 200 Indian rupees to 500 Indian rupees per kg. It means between $2 to $5 per kg. Next food is Bhang Thandai. Place all over city of Allahabad. Itwa has many authorized Bhang shop where Bhang is available in powdered form of a ready-to-mix paste, and you can ever buy it with thandai, a sweetened milk concoction with cardamom, pistachios, etc. Do not drink much because it gives intoxication. Price rupees 20 for a pellet. Yes, it's the cheap opiate. In UP, one place that you get all this food, there's Lucknow Street Food Bazaar. Address: Sector 2, Vrindavan Colony, Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. Moving to the next state, and it's West Bengal. First food from West Bengal is Tumba. Place purchased on a hillside on a quiet road just down from the Darjeeling Zoo. Or stimulating cafe, Hooker Street, Darjeeling. Next food is Rasagulla and multiple other sweets. KC Das Esplan Road, Kolkata is a base for Rasagulla. Price rupees 5 per Rasagulla. Next food, Kathi Roll, sometimes spelled Kathi. Is a Bengali street food origination from Kolkata, West Bengal. Today, mostly any wrap containing a filling and folded in an Indian flatbread roti is called a kathi roll. Price 20 for a paneer roll, 26 for mutton roll and double mutton roll egg, 58 rupees. it means around $0.6 to $0.8. So now let's move to the next state. And heart of the India, Madhya Pradesh. In Madhya Pradesh, Chinese bell, puri bhaji halwa and alu tikki are more famous. Place for this, Manohar Dairy and Restaurant Bus Stand at Bhopal. Price Chinese bell is 35 Indian rupees and puri bhaji halwa is 45 rupees per plate. Food, besan chillas and hot almond milk. Place, Civic Center area, Jabalpur. It's a fun place with the delicious sights, sounds and smells of snacks being fried, mixed and served. A lot of families and couples come to eat here, and you also have the occasional well-oiled drunk beyond in the deep-fried offering. Price for Kesar Garam milk is only Rs. 10. Next food is Gajak. Place, Hira Sweet Russell Chowk, Jabalpur. A great stop to pick up some sweet memories of your time in Jabalpur. Price is around 140 rupees per kg upwards. Have fun rolling your tongue around not just the delicious food but the exotic names like Ramyun, Malaj, Panekok and Font as you enjoy a crisp morning sun while sipping on some fresh fruit juice. Highly recommended. Next food is Sarafa ke Paratha. Paratha are one of the most eaten dishes in India. Sarafa is a well-known marketplace in Indore and is also known for a famous spot called the Adesh Shahi Paratha, where you can try all kinds of paratha. From paneer paratha to potato sev paratha, you can get whenever you wish. In Sarafa Bazaar, you can find most of the street food Madhya Pradesh and is in Indore. Don't miss to visit Sarafa Bazaar when you go to Indore, Madhya Pradesh for awesome street food experience. We have not much time to mention all varieties of India, so I am going to focus some of the South Indian dishes too, that you don't want to miss in your India tour. First South Indian dish is the dosa, the poster boy of Tamil Nadu food, dosa. There are so many types of dosa. There are a few famous kind of dosa which are available all over the country. Let's start with paper dosa. Most of the dosas are paper, thin and like all the other Tamil Nadu food. It is made by a batter with a mixture of urad dal and rice. Spread over the pan and cook mildly. It is then shaped into a thin paper like layer and served in a cone shape along with some chutney and sambar. All the other dosas are made in the same way, but depending on their names, the extra ingredients are added. Like the egg, dosa has the same procedure, but an egg is cracked and poured onto the dosa, spread across the cook along with the dosa in some oil or ghee. Some other kinds of dosa are tomato dosa, onion dosa, rava dosa, vegetable dosa, plain dosa, masala dosa, Chinese dosa, cheese dosa, paneer dosa and many more. And if you are in a group, then never miss to taste 2 feet long dosa. Must try this. Next food is banana bonda. It tastes as good as it looks banana bonda. I know all of you have seen and eaten bondas, but this bonda has a different stuffing to cook in the same way. Instead of adding potato and other veggies to it, stuff it with banana, which is then fried in oil. Constructing the usual spicy bonda, this is a sweet due to the banana and is eaten as a snack with tea. Tamil Nadu food never ceases to amaze. Next food is Idli Vada. Idli and Vada collectively serve breakfast for people who are late in the morning, almost every time. These Tamil Nadu food items complete each other beautifully and are total comfort foods. Idli is made with a mixture of urad dal and rice and looks like a small spongy and pancake once cooked and is one of the signature dishes of Tamil Nadu. Next food in Mendu Vada with sambar and coconut chutney. Mendu Vada is a popular known as vadai or garelu. This is a donut shaped crispy and floury vada made from lentils. This savory food made by grinding split black gram and then soaking it to the batter and finally frying in oil in small portions. Apart from this, ginger, onion, pepper, green chilies, cumin are also added to increase the taste. Finally, it is then served with coconut chutney and sambar. Next food is pongal. This is a staple meal during every auspicious festival of Tamil Nadu. Besides the rice and sweet milk, the dish is cooked with ingredients like cardamom, green gram, raisins, and cashew nuts. According to the traditional belief, pongal is cooked in an open space in the sunlight as it is dedicated to the sun god. The dish has two variants, one that's sweet, another that's savory, which is served on banana leaves. Pongal is cooked in a colorful clay pot that's decorated with the patterns called kolam. Next food is Kunji Panyaram. Panyaram is a South Indian dish that's made of steaming batter using mold with cavities. The dish was various names in other states of South India, such as Paddu in Kannada and Gunta Pongadu in Telugu. People have experimented with the dish in many ways. It can be made spicy, savory, sweet depending on your likes. Only ingredients like jaggery, chilies, masala vari, there is a special pan that's used to make panyaram. It is a pan with many small fishes. Apart from the given names, panyaram is also called as gulittu, gundapondu, monganalu, gulippa, appa, and so on. It's very difficult to pronounce. One of the interesting things that South Indian people serve food in banana leaves rather than the plate. It is the pretty different experience when you take food in banana leaves. It is one of the most eco-friendly disposable food serving system. After the dinner or lunch, don't miss to take ice gola. Whoa.
That's how you're supposed to eat gola.
This is so good.
And you again dip it and again do that.
What?
You again dip it.
These aquatic dishes are surely gonna get you the best foodgasm you ever feel. Hence, to all the food lovers out there, make sure you try these dishes whenever you visit India. I guarantee you guys, once you had all these food dishes, there is no going back. You are gonna be the fan of Indian curry and dishes for the rest of your life for sure. So guys, that's me for today. Hope you liked the video. Share your thoughts in the comment section and let me know if you want anything specific to know. Have a great day. Stay tuned for my new content. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Namaste.